Alright, I'm on the draw here, and yeah, this hand looks fine. Hopefully the parallel smear gives me enough time to cast all these turn to slags, which seem pretty excellent against him. That card's good. Never saw any of those. Being at one means Kemba's Skyguard saved me last game. Sweet. Not think I'm going to block when he attacks next turn, since I've got better things to do with my Parallel Spear. Because presumably he's going to play a guy that's actually better than that, and then I can block. Alright. What's he trinketing up? Life Staff. That card is quite good. And I don't mind him playing equipment because I've got these, still had all these turn to slags. So he's just gonna bash with the Trinket Mage here. Just block the Skyguard. I think with all these cards in my hand, I'm kind of the control here. And with all these Chrome Steeds in my hand, I'd rather keep the Perilous Mirror around. Alright, well, not a bad card to draw. The land would have been good too. Let's see, a Life Staff. Put it on his mirror. No, there's no point in doing that. Yeah. I'm just gonna take it here. Hopefully draw land for the steed on my turn. Jeez, more action. Alright, well, not bashing. That means I'm only one mountain away from me all to turn a bunch of stuff into slag. Hopefully he doesn't keep Nurokrup coming up. Though since he knows I have two turn to slags, he's probably going to. Let's play another Chrome Steed. Now he can't turn off Metalcraft. And start getting in there. Yeah, I'll trade, I think, for Nurok Replica. That trade seemed fine. Nurok Replica is going to be very annoying with all the spells in my hand, so I really don't mind. Sure. Boom. Go to 11. Hopefully taps out for something. Alright. Alright, he does not have Disperse. I have figured that one out. Let's just attack with this one. I'll get the Dark Slick Drake soon enough. I just didn't want to Galvanic Blast him last turn, because if he disperses my Chrome Steed or something like that in response, just a huge blowout. Riddle me this. What's better than Island? A Glintalk. Why is that going infinite? And he gets to loot again. Keep getting in there with Chrome Steed. Question is whether I want to turn something to slag. And no, I don't think I do. I think I'll wait a little bit. He's got so many equipment in his deck that I might as well wait. And I can just bolt something on my turn. Probably his Glint Hawk, since no reason to give him a card. That would cost 6. Sunblast Angel. Oh, that's no good. If I'm going to blast the Glint Hawk, it doesn't actually matter whether I do it now or not. In response, Fulgent Distraction. Tap your Sunblast Angel, tap your other guy. Alright. At least I got the blast still. Or the slag. Alright. And. Sure. Clasp up the flyer, then I can turn into O2 and not kill it after that. Well, I put a bunch of removal spells, so that's good. Yep, Strider Harness. Alright, I go to 5. And the next turn I take 1, go to 4. And then that's it. Perilous Mirror holding off his other guys here. Discards another Silver Mirror. Alright. Ooh. Yeah, I don't really feel like using that right now. I'd rather revoke like a Nim Death Mantle or something much more threatening. My deck certainly does have a lot of removal. Slag, Blast, Slag, Clasp, Revoke. Glint Hawk. That's no good. He probably wanted to tap that Silver Mirror for mana. Yeah. Alright, so I guess I go down to 2 here. I would say I'm in trouble. I think that's a fair description of this situation here. Any amount to get in the next draft. That would be Owen Turnwald. Playing around a third turn to slag there. Ooh, grind clock. Not quite good enough. Alright. Looks like on to the next game. He's got a bunch of flyers. He's got a Sunblast Angel. Ugh. Could put in Vigilance thing to play around Sunblast Angel. But that doesn't seem all that good, because all those guys fly, and so making my guys tougher. Well, I guess it makes my Sky Guards tough enough to battle with his stuff. Yeah, I'll take an Oriok Replica. That guy's not that good anyway.